folks, Will from MinIO here with a little how-to on listing objects in MinIO using our .NET client API. In this video, we're going to be using .NET version 6, and we're going to be listing objects out on play.min.io. That's our online sandbox where anybody can connect and work with the MinIO platform. And last but not least, we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio 2022 for Mac. So our focus in this how-to is going to be the list objects async method. But as usual, our methods are going to require an args object. And in this case, we're going to have the list object args. And I want to get into a little bit on the fact that we're going to be working with observable results. So let's take a look at our code. And as you may have seen in some of our other how-tos, our main method is going to be connecting to play.min.io for us, and it's going to be handling all of our exceptions for us as well. So the main call that's going to happen here is this run method, which accepts a MinIO client. You may notice, different from our other how-tos, that this is no longer an asynchronous method that returns a task. And that is because our list objects async method, while it is asynchronous, does not actually return a task this time. It returns an observable list. And this list of observable items, each item is part of our MinIO data model, and has information about it like names, version IDs, and all that other fun stuff. So let's go ahead and run this. I'm going to connect to play.min.io. I'm going to connect to our .NET demo bucket. That is being put into our list object args with the with bucket method here. And then I'm going to actually list out all of the objects that are in that bucket. So let's go ahead and run this. And what you notice here is that there's actually no output. Now, I promise you, there are actually objects out there for me to list. So what's the issue? Well, again, the list objects async method is an asynchronous method, which means that it's going to run, it's going to hand some stuff back. What's happening here is my process is actually ending before it can actually get all of the list of objects and process them in this observable subscribe call. So what I need to do is I need to put a little thread sleep in here. And this is something you may need to do as well if you're working with this particular code. Since I don't have a lot of objects out there, I'm just going to do a thread sleep for about 1 second, and that should fix everything for me. Let me go ahead and save that and we'll run it again. And when I run it again, this second time with that thread sleep, now I can see I have a couple of objects out there in my .NET demo bucket. I have an image and I have that hello world text. So that is just a very simple demonstration of the list object args for a bucket name, but what if I want to put some more information out there? So there's other things that I can pull down. So if I have a prefix, like a directory in my bucket, I can use a particular prefix. If I want to recurse down through my different prefixes, I can do with recursive true. I can also get a listing of versions. I can get any headers. And last but not least, I can use this with list objects v1. Now, Amazon S3 has a V1 and a V2 for listing objects. V2 is actually much more performant, so typically you're going to want to use that. So really the only thing I'm going to add here, since I know I don't have any prefixes, I know I don't have any recursion I need to do, is I am going to do this with versions, and you do need to tell it true or false. So there is my with versions true, and I'm going to add here a dash, and I'm going to grit the item version ID. So I can pull that version ID back out of the item as well. And we'll go ahead and save this. We'll run this one more time. And actually I have a bunch of versions up there. So this is the same image, the same hello world that I've been using for a few of these videos now. So I have a lot of different versions out there already. But that is basically what you can do with our list objects async method, and also how you can get your values back and how you can view them. So thanks very much for joining us for this how-to. If you'd like to connect with us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. You can always interact with us on minio.slack.com, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. We'll see you for the next one.